everybody. Welcome to the neural engineering section. And I would like, first of all, to thank the organizers of the first Congress, World Congress of Biomedical Engineering in Xi'an. And let us address the organizers and the participants. History of humankind is defined by technological revolutions, which come like waves. Now we are approaching such a wave. Those nations who will ride that wave will rule the world. And those nations who will reject that wave will sink and drown. This approaching technological revolution is called quantum leap. We see that Western countries, guided by the United States, reject and sabotage the quantum leap based upon the premise of exhaustible resources. They hope to gain world domination via the pre-quantum leap obsolete technologies of global artificial intellect, BCI, brain-computer interface, and brain chips. Their goal is to create a two-caste society consisting of cyber slaves who would become robo-sapiens, and their masters who would remain human but would gain superhuman abilities. Their goal is total mind control, and their means is biohacking via covert psychotronic war against civilians worldwide, across the border destruction of human genome via Monsanto-style genetic modification, occult DNA computing, and illicit distribution of nanochips in chemtrails and vaccines all around the world. Because of the transnational character of this danger, every country in the world should, as of today, create and distribute means for psychotronic defense of its citizens and make sure that the government creates the banks of wave matrices, bioholograms of the intact, healthy humans. The proper name for transhumanism is genetic collapse without a promise for the eternal life. We are at war, and this war is the World War III, which is the psychotronic and genetic warfare. Victory in this war, the defense of citizens against psychotronic weapons, and the advance of the quantum leap is impossible without creating a theory of neural engineering. Either we agree with Elon Musk that human brain is feline in comparison with the artificial brain of the machine and get destroyed together with this planet, or we continue the tradition of our ancestors, joined for Russia and China, who had supernatural psychic abilities above and beyond any machine. Quantum leap is first of all about the cultivation of such humans, those who are able to destroy an implanted chip and an attacking psychotronic generator via the sheer strength of their brain activity. These superhumans will also be able to operate quantum generators for transmuting inexhaustible resources and energy from the quantum vacuum for the sovereign and self-sufficient human communities. Cultivation of such humans is the major task for any country as of today, since in 5 years from now it will be too late. This is the central task for the neural engineering. Now let me start my presentation, which is remote biomedical engineering via mastering the geometrical optics of chromosomes. The same gene gets expressed in dysfunctional individuals by acrocentric chromosome and in functional individuals by metacentric chromosome. Individuals and species with extra acrocentric chromosomes exhibit mental disability or some degree of mental deterioration. Here we see acrocentric chromosome on the left and metacentric chromosome on the right. The chromosomes consist of two chromatids combined together in the X form and so having the swastika cross shape. The two chromatids intersect in the center where they exchange their genetic material. Metacentric chromosomes are the X-shaped chromosomes with two arms that are equal in length. Acrocentric chromosomes are chromosomes with two arms that are not equal in length, meaning they exhibit gross asymmetry. The acrocentric chromosome has the center which is not symmetrically removed for the same distance from the two ends of the chromatids. I argue that both our chromosomes and our brain function analogously to our eyes according to the laws of geometrical optics in holograms. The shape of chromosomes is so crucial since such a geometrical shape literally cannot get the focus or the zero center in the hologram. Our chromosomes and our brain function via the geometrical codes of refraction in the liquid crystal media. The Przewalski horse and the domesticated horse have absolutely identical DNA from the biochemical point of view. But the wild horse and domesticated horse widely differ not only by their appearance, but also by their physical strengths and cognitive abilities. And domesticated horse does not only know more functions, but it possesses much more strength and endurance than a wild horse. And the only difference between the Przewalski horse and the domesticated horse is that their homologous genes, genes that have the same function, have chromosomes which have different geometrical structure in the wild horse and the domesticated horse. The wild horse has acrocentric chromosomes, and the domesticated horse has metacentric chromosomes, different in shape from acrocentric chromosomes. Apes differ from humans in the same way as wild horses differ from domesticated horses. Genes in apes, which are homologous to specific human genes, differ from human genes only by the structure of their chromosomes. Human chromosomes are metacentric, while the homologous genes in apes have acrocentric chromosomes. Apes are lower than humans in their cognitive abilities, in the same way as wild horses are lower in their cognitive abilities in comparison to domesticated horses. The same is true of humans with Down syndrome. Children with Down syndrome have extra acrocentric chromosomes. Children with Down syndrome differ from normal children by the failure in the optical geometry of their chromosomes. These are the proofs that neural engineering is based upon the geometrical optics of bioholography from macro to micro dimensions and from molecular to atomic to subatomic levels. Evidently, the acrocentric chromosome is the result of the destruction of the metacentric chromosome, literally, it's splitting into halves. Analogously, male gender chromosome, which is acrocentric, is the result of degeneration of female gender chromosome, which is properly metacentric. Here we see a male and female gender chromosomes. Analogously, the shortening of telomeres is crucial for genome, only because it leads to the destruction of the proper geometrical shape of chromosomes. One can compare the geometrical shape of the acrocentric chromosome and the malfunctioning brain hologram to the shape of the myopic eye, which gets the focus of the retina and so cannot properly function. The holograms of a chromosome and of a brain out of focus results in the malfunction of the entire organism. Human enhancement is possible only through mastering the geometrical optics of chromosomes and the geometrical optics of our brain via bioholography. Now neural engineering fails since it does not account for the geometrical optics of chromosomes and the geometrical optics of brain signals, leading to the destruction of genomes and mass mental deterioration. The same way we use lenses to correct eyesight, We can use special lenses to correct geometrical optics of chromosomes and geometrical optics of our brain activity. My companies, Matrix City Distribution and Wave Genome R&D, created such lenses as electret-based chips coated by laser on nanolevel with the digitized bioholograms of healthy organs and physiological systems, the digitized bioholograms of healthy children, and the digitized bioholograms of pharmaceuticals. Wave Genome and Matrix City also offer the remote treatment via distance laser signal and the comprehensive digital pharmacy consisting of 44 digitized bioholograms for the most important bodily organs and physiological systems. We have more than 300 digitized bioholograms of pharmaceutical drugs. Wave Genome preceded Google's Bioelectronic Drugs R&D program for 6 years of actual global sales and 50 years beyond R&D. I was the first researcher who commercially offered the remote laser treatment as quantum holographic by internet or HoloNet in 2013 ahead of anybody else in the field. In October 2017, I have finished the clinical trials for the chip structured on nanolevel via laser with a digitized biohologram of aspirin. Scientific group headed by me consisted of scientists from the Moscow Bauman State Science University, the largest and most important science university in Russia, of MIT level. We used a newly invented Russian laser spectrograph. A mathematical model to digitize the bioholograms was created by the same scientist who created the mathematical model for the new Russian top rocket Kalibr. The clinical trials was headed by Professor Alexander Volkov, the head of the Research Educational and Medical Center of the Moscow Bauman Science University. This new research offers a new level of precision and verification of polarized holography as neural and biomedical engineering. The clinical trial was a blind experiment and corresponded to all government laws and regulations. We had tested 19 participants. The results clearly demonstrated that in comparison with the placebo, the new chip invented by my company causes the body reaction similar to taking an aspirin pill. Here we see time of coagulation, time of reaction, clotting index, clotting time, etc. This successful verification experiment has provided my theory of biomedical engineering as geometrical optics of bioholography with the proof. The correct theory of neural engineering is the guarantee of our survival as a country, as an individual, and as a species. And the correctness of this theory depends on the correct understanding of the basic laws of nature. I claim that the most basic, most important law of nature is the holographic principle. Holographic principle states that universe is entirely in its every matrix point. Because only matrices have this connection to everything, only matrices are capable of self-consciousness and interaction with the other matrices. Firstly, the holographic principle means that every matrix is non-local. In relation to neural engineering, this means that the matrix of the individual brain overlaps and coincides with the matrix of the collective mind for the country, the planet, and the universe. One cannot map the brain based on the concept of brain in a vat, a so-called brain in a jar. Only the gruesome misunderstanding of this principle of quantum physics leads Elon Musk to conclude that humans have feline brains. Transhumanism is a gross misunderstanding of the quantum non-locality of human brain. Because human brain is non-local, one of its components is the infinite signal among its other finite components. This infinite signal is the uncreated and indestructible signal in nature of its non-locality in space and time. That is why no artificial intellect which is created and thus finite and destructible would be ever able to match human brain. This also means that Ray Kurzweil's promise of eternal life by becoming a swarm of nanobots is a sheer idiocy. We are already and ever The eternal, uncreated, and indestructible wave matrices, or holograms, and death is a desirable portal into other dimensions. Transhumanism is dangerous not via its inability to fulfill its promise of eternal life, but vice versa, by the impending danger of preventing humans from dying and artificially keeping them in this dimension as slaves. Secondly, the holographic principle means that since every matrix is non-local, it is entirely present in any other matrix. In relation to neural engineering, this means that we cannot map human brain without mapping the matrix of human community and solving major moral problems of communal living. Since every matrix is non-local, one cannot shield oneself with a wall from an orphan crying behind that wall. Wave information passes through the walls. Transhumanism demonstrates the gross inability of understanding that neural engineering is impossible without overcoming the Neanderthal social structures of alienation, parasitism, exploitation, and social Darwinism in a capitalist caste society. Quantum leap means social leap, and at the present moment, only China, as a socialist country, is capable of making the quantum leap and resisting the impending cyber war by the enemies of humanity who are calling themselves transhumanists and or satanists. Thirdly, the holographic principle means that since every matrix is non-local, any matrix cannot be described by any specific substance. It cannot be read in any narrow frequency range, terahertz, infrared, or any other range. At present, one cannot map brain based only upon 2% of the deciphered DNA and 5% of the deciphered brain activity. But the point is that DNA and brain would always preserve some components that cannot in principle be deciphered in this dimension. Holographic principle implies that structuralist nature of everything is the most important thing. This means that various phenomena, from finite to infinite, share the common structure, and precisely this structure allows their interaction. And understanding this structural code allows us to interact with the infinite. Let me explain. In 2012, I have formulated the major implication of the holographic principle. This implication explains the possibility of the remote control over biosystems, which is already empirically demonstrated and commercially offered by my companies Wave Genome and Matrix City. It says that if universe is entirely in its every matrix point, then every matrix point is not simply different from any other matrix point, but is unique. World is 93% energy and 7% particles, which are the concentrated energy. This energy exists as non-local and unique holograms. If you have two exact copies of the same unique non-local biohologram aka wave crystal, you can transmit signal remotely and instantaneously from one copy to another copy. Thus, you can perform neural engineering of one's brain remotely and with the unlimited speed, that is instantaneously, if you have recorded the copy of the hologram of one's brain. I call this transmission the non-local token neural link, or the neural link of the first order. Tokens or copies of the same matrix hologram can be located in the past or in the future, on the other planet or in the other dimension. But if tokens have structural identity, the transmission of the signal between identical tokens will be instantaneous and remote. For example, in 1999, the Institute for National Security in Russia has performed the remote lowering of blood sugar in a diabetic calf at a distance of 10 kilometers for the American Diabetic Association. Each matrix hologram exists in its own parallel dimension, and this puts limits on the remote instantaneous transmission of signals between the unique non-local matrices. to transmit signals remotely and instantaneously between two non-local unique wave matrices, holograms, we need to use the additional holographic signal or structural phantom. I call this type of remote neural engineering the non-local structural neural link, or the neural link of the second order. For example, in the 1970s, the USSR Medical Center at the Rocket Research Center was able to transmit morphological information of stem cell programming from pregnant goat to pregnant rabbit and vice versa, so that the she goat gave birth to a little goat with rabbit's ears and the she rabbit gave birth to a little rabbit with goat's horns. Russians used two polished copper convex lenses which were exactly calibrated. The convex polished shape is known for its ability to create a holographic signal. Analogously, our skull has the same ability. We think not only because of our brain substance, but also because of our skull shape, creating reflection and refraction of signals and transforming linear external signal into holographic signals. In the 1980s, I formulated a hypothesis that holograms function as refractive crystalline wave structures, aka wave crystals, which fold a signal by reflecting this signal upon itself due to polarization. Thus, the holographic signal is a folded signal. The process of folding creates refraction and focus. In 2014, I extended my 1980s wave crystal theory to the geometrical optics of chromosomes. I argue that the structure of the hologram is the structure of refraction in the scalar wave diffraction grating. Scalar wave emerges because the external signal gets reflected upon itself due to the polarization in the hologram. Polarization emerges due to the change of the spin in the integral torsion of the DNA. The same applies to the brain activity. When the wave is reflected upon itself, the peak of the forward-going wave is neutralized by the trough of the same wave when it is reflected upon itself, and the scalar or standing or zero wave emerges. Its interference or diffraction grating possesses coherence for the further refraction of the following external signals towards the zero center of the wave crystal. Our eyes, our DNA, and our brain function based upon the same structural principle, that is via refraction. Changing the internal structure of the wave crystal and thus its refraction, we receive and transmit different information. Therefore, any neural engineering can exist only as the change in the internal structure, the geometrical code of the diffraction grating, wave interference, that changes the refraction of the external signal towards the zero center or the focus of the brave wave crystal. Well-performing brain is analogous to a well-performing eye, centered and focused, and badly performing brain is analogous to a myopic or farsighted eye or eye with double focus. In fact, schizophrenia is the existence of two disparate focuses in the brain. It is clear that the holographic signal should have all wave characteristics correspondent to the size and shape of the skull and should have the appropriate range of simultaneous frequencies from high to low, so that these two principles should be fulfilled: the reflection as the boomerang or reciprocity principle, and second, the refraction towards the focus according to the laws of geometrical optics. Again, we receive information only through the focus of the biohologram, through the zero center of wave crystal. This information is non-local in time and space and cannot in principle be delivered by local finite means. Thank you. So I will be happy to hear your questions. Yes?
I'm sorry, because of my research is not not in this field. I do some research on the material. And you talked about the neural engineering. And, is that mean you're the mastering the geometric of the chromosome? Is that you will know the structure of the chromosomes? Is there any relationship between the biomedical engineering between relationship between the biomedical engineering and the structure of the chromosomes?
Well, my point was that there is the structural law, which is true of any level of existence. You see, any scale from macro levels to micro levels. So the same structural principle is true for the universe, the galaxy, and the chromosome, you see, and subatomic levels, you see. So if we know this principle, we can use this principle, the same principle, to control climate, geophysical processes remotely, and biosystems, you see. So the same principle, the same law. And the principle consists of creating the refraction in the coherent scalar wave diffraction grating, because only the scalar wave creates the coherent diffraction grating, you see?
You mean that
so this is the point.
Different, different field share the same principle, you mean?
It's the same principle, you see? If you know this principle, you can control weather without heart. You can control weather with a small tabletop laser, or even without any laser, just by this, by your mind. You see?
Thanks for your attention.
Yeah. Any more questions?
Yes? You mentioned the matrix. What consists this matrix? Is it by human being or by some object or some material or what?
Matrix is a mathematical notion.
Oh.
It's a high mathematics. It's from mathematics. Matrix is the systematic whole of some structural features. You see, this is what matrix is. It's a systematic whole, which is structured mathematically. So you can get the, the specific numbers out of it and some geometrical codes out of it, you see? So this is matrix. It's not simply the fantasy of the Hollywood.
Thanks.
Any
questions? It's not my field of work. I'm trying to, I guess my question is, what kind of implication do you think your principle may have in, for example, in the biomedical field, and you use the examples of the children with the Down syndrome and compared with the healthy individuals. Do you project, do you anticipate your model or your principle may have some clinical application?
Well, this is the point, it's not theory. My company, you see, I'm an entrepreneur, basically. So I have very successful companies, you see. I successfully sell digitized bioholograms, you see? I sell them in three forms, as chips, structured by laser on nanolevel, clinically proven to have specific qualities, and then as digitized biohologram in comprehensive digitized pharmacies. You see, I sell bioelectronic drugs. You see, Google just wants to sell, but I already sell for many years. And thirdly, I sell remote laser management of biosystems via the distant laser signal. So it's all not on simply research and development. It's beyond research and development. I commercially
so
offer it, you see?
This way gave us, I assume that you
so Down syndrome children,
have
you
some
see,
application, is that right?
They can, yes, Down syndrome children can be treated only via polarized bioholography, you see? So their chromosomal geometry should be corrected, you see? In the mothers, you
so
see, in their mothers.
So that's a theoretical speculation, right? It's just a anticipation, I guess. You're hoping one day your theory can be applied in...
No, you didn't understand. I already sell it.
You already sold it, yes.
Yes,
you sold
for
your
many
products.
Years.
But the question is, has it been tested in clinic?
Yes.
Did you show some evidence?
Yes, this is the evidence. By Bauman University, I tested aspirin right now.
Did you show us some case? As you said, it has been tested, but I didn't see any data, any information you presented. Maybe you just didn't include it.
Well, 20 minutes is not enough, so I'm already over the time. But this is the structure of the one of the devices used, and this is the data. Okay. This is the data of the coagulation. So this is aspirin, which was recorded as a biohologram, digitized by the mathematical model. And then this mathematical model was used to structure the chip on the nanolevel. And this chip, you see, I'm wearing one of such chips, you see? So this is a chip inside the casing. This is a psychotronic defense chip.
Right. I know time is running out.
Yes.
That's a very quick question. How many participants?
19 participants.
Okay.
It was a small, but it was the blind clinical trial, blind experiment.
Mm-hmm.
And it was done by professionals of the Bauman Science University of MIT level. So this is the data. This is the proof that this works. So, let us proceed to the next speaker, and the next speaker is Long Mei.
Yeah.
Senior Research Assistant, Beth Israel, Deaconess, Medical Center, USA. And the title is A Potential Activation Blocking Mechanism of High Frequency Stimulation on Axons. Welcome.